So right now we've only got 3 tabs up here, which is a bit lame. It would be really good if we had tabs for all these models here, so author, category, and post. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to add those in. So I ran Rails generate and I found there's a really useful method called ActiveAdmin resource. What that will do is it'll generate a file in here for that model, which is quite cool. So that's just made the author. So if I was to go here, authors has just appeared and I can see all the authors which are in that database, which is quite cool. So I'm going to go ahead and do that for post and for category. Okay, cool. There you go. You can see them all there. It kind of knows about the authors and stuff, which is very neat. Plus, you can even do a little search. Very nice. So right now, this post page, it's got a lot going on. There's a lot of fields. I can imagine this body field's going to become quite big over time. Like, assuming these are like actual blog posts, that could be like a huge text field. So let's kind of tweak this a little bit. I'm going to add this little block of code where I say on the index, we're going to have the following columns, a selectable column, which is that little dot, the ID, the title, the author, the credit, and actions. That's all I want to see on this index, and I think it will auto add this title. So yeah, that's what it just did. That's pretty cool. These filters on the right are a little bit messy as well. This is a lot going on. What we're going to do is we're going to limit those a little bit, just to be a few. So by default, ActiveAdmin will just kind of do it on every field. However, as soon as you add one, it'll limit it to just that one filter. So now I'm filtering by the title. And if I was to maybe go to the author now, oops, then I could filter by the author's been a drop down. However, I could also do author underscore name. And remember, this is a reference over here. So we could probably, yeah, filter by their name. And that uses ransack, which is quite magical. So you have a lot of options there. So let's quickly drop in a few. That looks pretty good. One other thing we'd probably want to filter on is this published at. So it's quite likely we'd want to only show posts which are published. So I think what I'll quickly do is I'll add thing in here, published. I think that's it. Oh, published. Yeah, there we go. Nice little Boolean operator. We're going to add a scope called published. And this is actually kind of a magical one, where if I was to go to RailC, quickly load up a post, and do .published to SQL, you'll see it's actually auto-generating that. And that comes from this has event magic, which is a gem. So just in case you're wondering where that came from. By the way, we have a scope called published on all the posts. And if I was to bang one in there, okay. We click it, we get to see all the ones which are published. So let's quickly make a post published. So the way I've done that is with a published at field. So if this published at has a value, then we assume it's published. Okay, so we've got it in there. There we go, one of the posts is now published, and that's going to be yes. So that's really nice. So now if we want to only see the published ones, we click that for One of the big gotchas of ActiveAdmin is the first time you go to submit a form, you get this error, and it's the forbidden attributes error. And if we jump back into our code and we look at another one of our kind of boilerplates, you notice it has a big block explaining what this is, and it says we just have to add in the argument permit params. So that's pretty cool. So let's do that. Let's go down here, and so we're going to permit changes to the title, the body, and the author ID. So I'm going to change the title, New Watch 2020, and there we go. It's just changed. So that's quite cool. But if you go back to this form, it's also not very nice. This is the published at date, and we don't really want to be showing users that. There's a categories which are connected to it. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to our code. We're going to create a form now, and it's actually super straightforward. You have a block called form do, and within that is everything around this form. So in this case, we can have the title, the body, the author, and then we're going to show some categories and some actions. So there you go, title, body, author, and some categories. So let's change some categories and do new eWatch 2021. Okay, that's pretty cool. Let's go edit. Okay, so I'm pretty sure I just clicked peers. So why did that fail? Well, when you look at this, you notice that it's a array we want. So when you're sending like multiples, you need to permit the array param, or permit that parameter to accept an array. You should do doing that, which is kind of weird when you look at it, but let's change these all around. Apple pairs and text. All right, edit. Sweet, it just updated. That's very cool. One thing which I think we're missing here is, so we just went to that show page, and it's not actually showing that much either. So you're probably not going to be surprised to know that to edit the show page, you do show do. And then kind of like the index, you just fire out a bunch of like columns. However, the only caveat is you put them in an attributes table. So yeah, there we go. There's the categories we just added at the bottom there. If I wanted to only show the categories, just have that row. And if I didn't have the attributes table, it would just look a bit weird. So yeah, that's the only thing you really need to know about that show. And you can also turn off and on the comments by removing that, which is very cool.